Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
So you join us now for the Gundog Group Saturday evening sparkling parade of the fabulous Gundog breeds that have been judged today here at Crufts. 31 breeds. So here comes our judge, a glittering welcome for her, a very well-respected all-round judge in the UK, Zena Thorne Andrews. First that we're going to see is a lap of honour from this beautiful Legotto Romagnolo and multi and international champion Alfredo is his name, he's come all the way from Italy to compete, and in the Any Variety Imported Register classes. The Imported Register, of course, the place where breeds still in development in the UK are shown. They're not on the full breed register yet, but they will be once sufficient bloodlines and enough quality has been imported to this country to make sure we breed happy, healthy dogs. Beautiful example of the breed.
Yes, it's nice that he's come all the way from Italy to support the breed classes here. The breed in those import classes.
Now the first of our best of breed winners for Crufts 2013's Gundog Group, all the way from the Netherlands, the Bracco Italiano.
There's our little Brittany coming in, native breed of France.
And the English setter, judged by none other than Frank Kane today.
And here comes the German long-haired pointer.
The German short-haired pointer.
And here comes the German wire head pointer, the biggest of the varieties. The Gordon Setter, black and tan, striding out well.
Next we have the Hungarian Wiesla, followed by the Hungarian wirehead Wiesla.
Here's the red and white setter.
And from one of the larger entries in the group, the Irish setter, ever popular.
Another Italian breed, the Italian Spinoni, with his pounding trot coming across the carpet.
And the little Koikerhunje.
A native breed of the Netherlands.
The large Munsterlander.
Now the large Munsterlander.
The pointer.
Here's the stylish pointer coming in, a black and white one, big entry today. Over 250.
And the first of our retrievers, this one, the Chesapeake Bay.
Here's the curly coat, the biggest and tallest of the retriever breeds.
The ever popular and smiling face of the flat coat retriever.
From the huge entry of golden retrievers, we have a bitch coming in now. And from Italy, all the way to top the Labrador entry.
The little Nova Scotia duck tolling retriever receiving challenge certificates for the first time today at Crufts.
And there's the American Cocker with Susan Crummy coming in.
The heaviest of the Spaniels, the Clumber.
Lovely red Cocker Spaniel bitch coming in now.
Followed by the English Springer Spaniel.
Lovely, clean front stride there.
And the Field Spaniel.
Here comes the Irish Water Spaniel, winner of the Gundog Group at Crofts last year.
The Sussex Spaniel.
The lowest of the Spaniel breeds, lowest on the leg, the Sussex Spaniel coming in. Distinctive golden end to his coat.
And the beautiful Welsh Springer Spaniel.
The Spanish Water Dog.
Ah, Spanish Water Dog getting very popular in this country. This one bred in Spain.
And the last of our gun dogs to join the group tonight, the Weimaraner. Now we have Zena Thorne Andrews, our judge for tonight in the Gundog group, taking a look at all the breeds, best of breed winners that have come into the group ring. This is her first opportunity to have a really good look at what the judges, the breed judges in the breed rings have given her. Going down the line here.
Looking for outline and balance. General overall appearance of the breed, very important.
German Wirehead, Vizsla, the Irish Red and White, the Irish Setter, one of the most popular, the Italian Spinoni, I do love those dogs. Pointer and the Retrievers.
The wagging flat coat tail.
Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever, the first of our Spaniels, the American Cocker, there's the little Cocker.
There's the Irish Water Spaniel, the lovely Sussex. Spanish Water Dog and the Weimaraner just getting into position.
Now, following Zena Thorne Andrews' walk around and her initial appraisal of each breed, we come to the first breed to be examined, the Draco Italiano. The breed was judged today by Miss Caroline Fry. It was a breed entry of 57 made by 48.
Now, Zena Thorne Andrews going over the first of these gun dogs, the Braco Italiano Valentino di Regioni Monte Arnoso from the Netherlands, owned by Chris Van Holland and handled by Daphne, bred by Franz Kuylden and handled by Daphne van Brink.
The athletic stride of the Braco Italiano. They should be lean, athletic, divergent planes of the head, striding out well. Hunt, point and retrieve are very versatile and very stylish in the show ring.
Now the Brittany, this one show champion, an Irish show champion, Easternight Didi avec Lesort, owned by Ian and Margaret Trossel, handled by Margaret in the ring, bred by Amanda Ellis.
And a very distinctive gait on the Brittany, whereas many of the Gundogs have a long striding, the Brittany is not. It's got a brisk stride, it's got moderate angulation in the shoulders, moderate angulation in the hind legs, so its steps are only of moderate length. Rather like a cob, they're compact and cobby.
Real business-like little gun dog who's decided to stop and do its business.
Very business-like.
Very embarrassing moment for the handler, but every dog handler and owner understands when it's got to be done, it's got to be done. The graceful outlines of the English Setter. This one, Moorbrook Uptown Flirt at Pernickety. Judged by Frank today, owned by Sharon Cook. Handled in the ring by Sharon, bred by Lorna and Ken Howarth.
And topping a lovely entry, 208 English Setters here today. this one winning her second challenge certificate. Now the setters should be full of style, that lashing tail, head carried high and striding out well. This one an orange Belton and really enjoying it in the big ring there.
They're such graceful dogs, English setters. I don't think her tail stopped for a second there. Zena going over the German long-haired pointer now, one of the rarest of the breeds in the Gundog group. Irish show champion Aranese Falco, 3 years old, owned by Brenda Moss, handled by Mike Blay and bred by Brenda.
These are actually the tallest of the German pointers. And of course, whereas the others were traditionally docked, these have never been docked. They've always had the long tail on them. And really striding out here. They are hunt, point and retrieve. They can do everything a gun dog is called to do. Search, point, and actually go and retrieve the game.
By contrast, a cousin, the German short-haired pointer, this one show champion and Dutch champion, Cavacani Toff at the top. Judged by Carol Coode today, owned by Adam Rose and James Gaffney, handled by Adam in the ring, bred by Sue and Pete Rose. And of course, earlier on at Crufts today, we saw this kennel doing very well in the Breeders' Stakes final.
The German short-haired pointer is absolutely functional in its build. It should have economical strides, a weatherproof coat, nothing exaggerated at all. Really stretching out in the front and a firm top line. That's a weatherproof coat it's got. It's quite harsh to the touch.
Slightly heavier frame, this one the German wirehead pointer, champion Trollingen's Grunner at Barrive, owned by Barbara and Sharon Pinkerton, handled by Sharon in the ring, bred by Annette Ellenson and Matty Palm.
Zena going over it well, feeling the muscle in the hind quarters, looking at the tail set. Beautiful shot of its head with that whiskers and eyebrows.
And of course, this one a full champion, meaning that it's got qualifications in the field as well as in the show ring.
And they're not just a wire-haired version of the German short-haired. They are, as you said, Jessica, bigger, more bone, a little longer in the body, much more sturdy. A very successful kennel here. Bred in Sweden, this one.
The grace of the Gordon setter, Shanaz Wave Dancer at Tarkulter, has a show certificate of merit, owned by Katrina McKnight, handled by Susan McKnight, her daughter in the ring, bred by Bonnie School.
The lovely headshot of the black and tan there, lovely eye and expression, rich tan markings on the muzzle, which are a requirement of the breed. These are the heaviest of the setters. They have strong bladed bone, that sort of flattish bone. Sturdy body, relatively short in the tail and lashing it like all the setters do. They are the most stylish of gun dogs.
And the coat, very important, but should never be so profuse, even on a show dog, that it could interfere with the dog's work. The Hungarian Vizsla, this one, Nikael Galicia, 2 years and 3 months old, owned by Anne Papworth, handled in the ring by her and bred by Maureen Wilkes.
Everything moderate about the Hungarian Vizsla. We can see the oily coat there. moderate bone. They're not a heavy breed. Again, they're HPR breeds that can do everything, and they're very popular in the field, and especially in Hungary, of course.
And as a hunter pointer retriever, we need balance, don't we? We need drive on the move, a strong dog that's able to go out and retrieve game as well as hunting for it.
And that beautiful russet colour, it's marvellous. It's the only colour in which the breed comes, and a slightly greasy touch to the coat.
Zina taking a careful look there. You can't hide anything under a coat like that. And a close cousin, the Hungarian wire-haired Vizsla. Langspar Shavasi, or Havasi, Havi, 4.5 years old, owned by Terry and Gillian Pearson, handled by Terry and bred by Gillian.
And again, we can see, almost feel the texture of that coat there. Harsh, crisp top coat and an undercoat to give it protection. Beautiful shot of the face, a powerful, strong muzzle for carrying game.
And these dogs don't have such profuse furnishings as the German wirehaired pointer, do they? It's quite a close, harsh coat there.
So therefore they have less whisker, less eyebrow, yes, and that's if they have too much, then it's a soft coat, which would be not good.
Glorious, crisp colour of the Irish red and white setter. Such a beautiful dog, this show champion, Coranru Connection. 7.5 years old, a veteran, but not looking like a veteran at all. Owned by Kath Griffin, who also handles in the ring, and bred by Graham and Jackie Bain.
Rich red islands of colour on the background of clear white. Sturdier than the Irish setter. Beautiful head. Chiseled eyebrows.
And should be graceful on the move. This one, a champion with 27 challenge certificates, 23 of them with best of breed, so one hell of a record.
It's hard to believe that last century they were almost close to extinction. So, whereas the red setter is one of the most popular of the gun dog breeds.
Now, as Frank said, far more numerous in terms of the numbers of dogs we'd see here at Crufts. The Irish setter, show champion, an Irish show champion. Northamber, Just Cause for Glenava. Owned by Christine McLaren, handled by Christine in the ring, bred by Mr. and Mrs. Hinsley.
There we go. We see this raciness. These are the racier of the setters. Beautifully chiseled eyebrows, dark eye, giving a lovely soft expression, and striding out well. A slightly sloping top line. Again, lashing tail, a hallmark of the setter breeds.
Deep chested, powerful dog. Now, one of my favourites in this group, judged by a real breed specialist in Carol Spencer, this is Una Volta Per Sempre Sorriso del Riccini, or Riccini probably is more correct pronunciation, owned by Suzanne Whittingham, Philip Wright and Christine Bexon, handled by Suzanne in the ring, bred by Arno Brands and Ellen Plazier in Holland.
And I know that's a particular favourite of yours, Jesse. You used to own this breed, of course, and you'll know what wonderful characters they are. Look at that wiry top coat. And a unique top line. There's a dip and a rise and a dip again. So it is one of the breed features in outline, and you can see it there as it moves off.
And this one showing great balance, the substance in the bone and construction of the dog, and yet an easy, free movement. That loping gait is incredibly important in the Spinoni. They should look like they can go all day.
And a pounding trot. It's a heavy gait, and retaining that top line.
A lovely dog, this one. Lovely dog.
Oh,
The little Coikahunja, another one with a lovely bright red and white coat. This one, Irish champion Crunchcroft Invincible, 6 years old, owned by Edwina Kennedy, who handles in the ring and also bred him.
One of the smaller of the Gundog breeds, Dean, is just looking at coat colour, but we can see in its ears those black ringlets, which are a hallmark. They have to have those black ringlets in their ear fringes.
Very different gait for a smaller, more compact dog on the move. Nice top line held and a beautiful shot of the head.
And a relatively lightly built, the Coikahunji. Very nice expression from dark eyes and dark pigmentation.
The classic lines of the large Munsterlander. This one, show champion Hannigdean Jack Daniels, 8 years old, so another veteran, looking very youthful though, owned by Miss Cheryl Dewar, handled by her in the ring, bred by Richard Marsh.
An absolutely functional breed that can do, again, versatile hunt, pointer and retriever, and they only come in this colour. The black and white or blue roan, largely black head with a white snip or blaze on its face.
A happy dog wagging that tail.
Sturdy bone and striding out there with some heart and lung room. Should be a slight slope from the withers down to the set of the tail.
Cena trying to attract his attention. He's more interested by what's on the carpet. Beautiful pointer. This one, Sean Philly Redshank for Rachida. Owned by Glynis Marsh, who handles in the ring, and bred by the Dyers.
A series of graceful curves is what the standard calls for. There should be nothing hard in the outline of the pointer. Now, should stride out stylishly. They're a real thoroughbred in the Gundog group. Head carried high allows them to scent, take up the game scent with its high head carriage.
And there should be that lashing, beasting tail, shouldn't they? This one a working dog as well as a show dog. So should be fit as a fiddle. Mm. One of the heavier retrievers, this one the Chesapeake Bay champion and Swedish champion Penrose Jack Tarr, the Penrose kennel of Janet Morris, a very famous one and no stranger to the group ring at Crufts, handled by Rebecca Morris, her daughter, in the ring tonight.
Great substance in this breed, and of course look at that oily coat, that weatherproof coat, it equips them to work in the icy waters. Zena feeling the oiliness in the coat texture. Strong bone, good depth of chest.
A solid dog, but should nonetheless be balanced and graceful, so it looks like it could work all
day. Yes, and the Penrose dogs are all dual purpose. They're all keen workers. Breeder Janet Morris is very keen on that.
The curly-coated retriever. This one, show champion Gladrags Diamonds Forever, nearly 3 years old, owned by Gladys Hayden and Charlotte Hayden as well, handled by Hayden Phillips in the ring.
Yeah, the black Astrakhan curls, which are the hallmark of the breed, give it its name, the curly-coated retriever. Wedge-shaped head, nicely moulded. It is the tallest of the retriever breeds.
And the coat is so classically important for this breed, isn't it?
Of course, this one is a black. They also come in liver colour. Now, looks very happy and relaxed in the ring. And so does Zena.
retriever. That couldn't be anybody else's tail, could it, other than a flat-coated retriever? This one, Flandrusa head over heels to Bordercott, owned by Rosalie Brady, bred by Christine Price, handled by Rosalie in the ring tonight, gleaming with condition, that beautiful black coat, and the happy nature of this breed means the tail should just never stop wagging.
And this is the raciest of the retrievers, which means it's got a bit of length in its body, clean flow from neck into shoulder, a glossy, weatherproof coat, and they love working. These are a real utilitarian gun dog. They love to work. Rosalie, a long-time interest in the breed.
And what a super piece of handling. Perfect pace all the way around to show the dog to his best.
This is our black-coated retriever best of breed, 12474.
A phenomenal entry of golden retrievers, as there always is across over 450 dogs. Top of them all, show champions, say them, Calamity Jane, 5 years old, owned by Anne Falconer, who also bred this bitch and handles her in the ring tonight.
Beautiful, soft expression. That's what makes the breed so popular. Now this one looks very nicely balanced. It's got good length of leg to balance the body depth. Very interested in the smells, but going out smartly.
Yes, and that won't be penalised. It's a gun dog after all, supposed to use its nose.
And holding a firm top line, tail coming straight off the back.
And another massive entry, and this one, Lochmore Romeo, has come all the way from Italy to compete. Belongs to Franco Barberi, who also bred him and handles him in the ring tonight.
Now, this is not the first time that Franco's come from Italy to take best of breed at Crufts. He's a wonderful breeder from the north of Italy. Very successful. His Labrador's all of beautiful type and beautiful temperament, yes.
I want to play, Dad. A big round of applause for one of the most popular breeds in the group, a solid workman of a dog.
Riding at that thick otter tail, double coated, big substance in the body.
The Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever, and Woody, Trevark the Entertainer at Briswood, has taken the first step towards being a champion today, winning a CC for the first time. Owned by Babs Harding and Elaine Whitehill, handled by Elaine, bred by Sandra and Gareth Hawkins.
And these are a breed that had an interesting job. They had to lure ducks within gun range, so it's said that their markings and the white tip on their tail, the activity of that attracted the ducks. And there you see the white tip wagging on its tail. Beautiful wedge-shaped head, rich red colouring and white up the pasterns and on the chest. And a little snip on the nose and head. That one's nicely proportioned and holding a good top line and correct tail.
On the table, the first of our Spaniels. This one, Afterglow, Pearl's a singer, an American Cocker Spaniel. Pearl, she's known at home, owned by Susan Crummy and Jason Lynn, handled by Susan in the ring, bred by Mike Gadsby and Jason.
The American Cocker head is more domed than the Cocker, although they did develop from the same tap roots. Until about 1948 or so, they were shown as one breed in the States, and then they divided. Beautiful large dark eyes there.
The breed has grown in popularity. As a breed that I've had the pleasure of owning since 1972, I can safely say that these sporting spaniels.
You see the different top line when it moves on this breed. There is a sloping top line and a higher set tail, as we'll see.
And under all that flashy coat, there's a working dog there, isn't there? There's a working gun dog.
They have to have bone and substance. They are essentially a sporting spaniel, and they were bred to retrieve quail. a smaller bird. The lovely hard top line, the perfect tail carriage on this bitch.
The Clumber Spaniel. This one, Big Booms Bandits Bex, 23 months old, owned by Lana Lavalli, handled by Mario Zambic in the ring. Lana bred the dog as well. And they've come from Zagreb in Croatia to compete at Crufts.
Again, proving how internationally popular Crufts is. This one looks beautiful temperament, standing loose and lashing its tail. Strong skull there. They're a relatively long-bodied dog and short legs, which gives them a slight roll to their movement, but again, they should be essentially very active. Can go through thick cover with all that substance. It's a very nice head. Wonderful top line and tail carriage.
A massive dog, but never too exaggerated. You've still got to bear in mind, we need to be able to go out to work. Delightful character, that one. The ever popular Cocker Spaniel. I'm sure there's many at home on the sofa with you watching the programme tonight. Show champion Canigou Storytime at Withyfloor. Owned by Sally Ellison from Tiverton in Devon. Bred by Patricia Bentley, of course, her famous Canigou kennel.
And we see the Cocker Spaniel much more moderate in its lines, more curved in its outline and gentle than the American Cocker we saw earlier. Cobby and compact and very merry. The merry cocker is the epithet.
Of course, shown with undocked tails now, so we can see the lashing tail even more than we would have been able to in the past. Happy little person.
And you see the more rounded croup or hindquarters of the cocker here.
The English Springer Spaniel, Peas Blossom Chance, is 5 years old, owned by Dave and Jackie Mitchell, who also bred this one, handled by Carolina Lindblom in the ring.
The highest on the leg of the Land Spaniel, so they've got good length of leg, good depth of chest, and beautiful bones we see there. Now we should see this forward swinging stride as he goes.
They're such stylish gun dogs, English Springers, in the show ring.
Absolutely. And I'm particularly fond of this one. Looks really well tonight. The liver and white, the most popular colour in the breed.
The Gentle Field Spaniel, Nadavin Quaney at Vraki, owned by Anne Menzies and Mr. Lendras. They come from Perthshire, handled by Anne in the ring and bred by the Holgates.
And this was a breed which was almost extinct between the two world wars, and it was only a handful of breeders and had to use an outcross to another spaniel breed to keep the breed going.
Wonderful expression there.
That leanness under the eyes and the almond-shaped eyes gives it a wonderful, noble expression and head.
They're relatively long in the foreface for spaniels too, which is very characteristic.
And the proportions to the body are different. There's sort of longer body, the rib cage going along the back about two-thirds of the way, and the dignified long stride. They should never be rushed. Here we see a nice, leisurely, dignified stride. There he goes. Relatively young dog, I think, this.
Next, we see the Irish Water Spaniel. Suzanne Webster was the breed judge today.
The unmistakable outline of the Irish Water Spaniel. American champion and champion whistle stops, Elements of Magic. owned by Judith Carruthers and Colleen McDaniel in the US, handled by Judith, of course, bred by Colleen and Stacey Duncan.
And we saw Zina just checking the webbed feet of the dog. They to work in water, so they've got these webbed toes and this protective coat. Curly, astrakhan curls, weatherproof.
And they don't shave their tails. The coat's always shorter on the tail, isn't it?
This dog bred in America, the Gun Dog Group winner here last year. When I judged this breed in Westminster just a few weeks ago, best of breed was this dog's sister, and runner-up another sister, so it's a very successful family. This is a dog who's very exuberant, as the breed tend to be, but tonight he looks to be putting his best foot forward.
Bless him, he's growing up, a little more settled. The Sussex Spaniel, show champion Jubilwell Mashona at Pindani. Owned by Kay Kenyon and Ian Smith, handled by Kay in the ring, bred by Bill and Julie Cadwell.
It was in 1795.
Now this is the lowest on the leg of the Spaniel breeds, an ancient breed, wonderful substance to it, and golden tips to its coat, this beautiful golden colour.
And look at the size of those feet. That is a solid, heavy dog. Plenty of bone there.
There it is. It will have a little roll because of the short legs and long body, but a lot of substance. This one, a lovely temperament and striding out. That coat has the texture of sealskin. It's a wonderful texture when you feel a good Sussex coat. Lovely domed skull, quite strong. That's very nice. I do like this.
Again, another one that used to be a docked breed, but now we see a lovely wagging tail there.
Breed typical movement. It's not rushed, it's correct for the breed.
The Welsh Springer Spaniel, Glenbrough's Time Lord, Theo, 3 years old, owned by Tim and Honor Harrison. Tim's handling in the ring, and this pair also bred this lovely dog.
Beautiful coat. This rich red and white is the only colour in which the Welsh Springer comes.
And Theo was made up at Crufts today, winning the third CC. He looks pretty relaxed about it all.
Slightly lighter in build than the English Springer we saw earlier. The head quite different. This should be have good length to it. Moderate length of back, moderate length of leg, and this distinctive rise over the top line and striding out cleanly in front.
Likes watching TV with the kids at home, apparently. Now, this one, a Spanish and Swedish champion, Curioso de la Ribera del Genil del Valentissimo. What a mouthful. Imported from Spain by Nigel and Jenny Eggington. Nigel's handling in the ring and bred by Salvi Cabrera Garcia, Spanish water dog.
And not for the first time is he best of breed at Crufts. Wonderful dense coat there to give him protection.
Solid, balanced little dog on the move.
Absolutely a good moving dog. Clean, coming accurately in front. Rectangular in its body shape. And this one, Nigel's taken him back to Spain and has won championships in Spain and in Sweden. That's a hallmark of a super dog.
In the field as well as in the show ring. Brains as well as beauty. The last of our gun dogs, this one, show champion Gunholt de-Icer Strideview of Weimarana, of course. Ice is 3 years old, owned by Karen Whitehead, bred, of course, by Stephen and Patsy Hollings, handled in the ring by Jackie Ward.
the Grey Ghost dog, and that comes from that metallic sheen in its coat. Beautiful gaunt quality to the head.
More graceful than some of the other hunter pointers, but nonetheless should be a strong and solid dog.
They should have substance in the rib cage. They're rectangular, so they have some length to the body, but the ribs should come well back. They have to have substance. And of course, a good long rib cage protects the heart and lungs and gives the heart room.
So that's the last of our gun dogs Zena's taken a look at. Who's she going to pick to win the group for 2013? So Zena Thorne Andrews taking a stroll down the lineup of her gun dog best of breed winners. Of course, she's going to make her pick first of all before deciding who's going to take the group. What do you think, Frank?
Well, I think it's a very even group tonight, so it'll be interesting to see what Zena comes up with. The Labrador went very well. With a lot of dogs have gone really well tonight.
I think she's got some strong contenders there.
Back here tomorrow, watch live on television, Channel 4, from 5:30 to 8 p.m, including the best in show competition.
She's come to the end of the line. Who's she going to pull? She's pulling the Weimaraner and the Spanish Water Dog.
The Irish Water Spaniel, last year's winner, comes out again. The American Cocker's coming out, and the Labrador, great cheer for him. The Chesapeake Bay, I thought Zena would like that one, so functional.
And she's taken the, is it the Wirehead Wiesler? She's taken the Wirehead Wiesler.
The German Wirehead Pointer and the German Shorthead Pointer. And the Bracco Italiano.
So that's quite a cut we've got there. We've got 10 to see move again.
Now we'll see Zena send them out and back to see their movement.
Starting with the Weimaraner, show champion Gunnel D-Ice at stride view. And then all the way around the ring, so we get a really good look at that movement.
Looking at top line and reach and drive.
Now the Spanish Water Dog, Spanish and Swedish champion Curioso de la Ribera del Genil del Valentissimo, imported from Spain to this country, a Spanish champion, but also having won in the field, so a working dog as well.
And really striding up with a lovely top line.
Last year's group winner, the Irish Water Spaniel, show champion and American champion, Whistle Stops, Elements of Magic.
And this is when the applause often gets to him and he comes very boisterous, but not so tonight.
The best of breed Irish Water Spaniel, 4667.
Looking very settled this evening. Still the delightful temperament of the breed on show, but a really nice look at that movement.
Here goes the American Cocker. This went very well earlier.
Show champion Afterglow Pearl's a singer. Only 22 months old, so still a youngster, really.
Beautiful long neck. Slightly sloping top line. She's been on very good performance here.
Delightful, actually. So the Labrador Retriever, Franco Barberi, all the way from Italy, bringing Italian champion Lochmore Romeo.
And that's a beautiful example of breed type and really powering his way with his hindquarters.
And an enthusiastic applause from the crowd.
I think he might go very close here.
Galloping around the ring so happily. The Chesapeake Bay Retriever now. This one, Swedish champion and champion Penrose Jack Tarr for Janet Morris.
Chesapeake Bay Retriever number 12363.
Steady, graceful mover. So balanced there.
Keep going round. This is where the handlers have to keep calm, keep the dogs at their best.
And the Hungarian wirehead Vizsla, Langhar Shevasi.
Weardale, County Durham, Terry and his wife Gillian have had notable successes with the breed. And another nice striding dog, lashing its tail.
The German wirehead pointer now, champion Trollingen's Runa at Bariv.
Strong, athletic. This kennel's hugely successful in the breed. Look at the length of stride on that dog.
Putting in a beautiful performance. And now the German shorthead pointer, show champion and Dutch champion, Kavakani Toff at the top.
Zina's chosen a very good shortlist here. They've all got a chance. They're all in with a shout here.
So graceful and elegant on the move, these gun dogs. Beautiful hunter pointer retriever breed. And this has got to be one of my favorites. I love these. The Bracco Italiano, this one, Valentino di Regione Montagnosa from the Netherlands.
That elastic gait, far reaching.
And this is a big, powerful dog. Nonetheless, look at the grace there. Well, perhaps not there. I'll jump up and have some fun.
Yes, that's right. Typical head planes of the breed, divergent head planes give it this lovely expression.
And very sound. So that's our final 10. The boards are coming out into the ring. Zina doesn't normally waste much time. Who is she going to take for the Gundog Group winner for 2013? It's the Italian Labrador, the Labrador Retriever. Italian champion Lochmore Romeo takes the group.
Wonderful dog, he's a beautiful Labrador, and Franco, he'll be delighted with that. He speaks very little English, but I'm sure he's very happy.
The Weimaraner comes into group two, show champion Gunnel Dice at Stride View. The beautiful German shorthead pointer, show champion and Dutch champion Kavakani top at the top into group three. And the Irish Water Spaniel won the group last year, has to be content with group four this year, but I'm sure they'll be chuffed to bits. So here's the winner of the Gundog Group for 2013, this beautiful Italian-bred Labrador.
And what a picture of balance and breed type there. Compact, big substance, excellent bone and feet, and that wonderful temperament. Look at that tail.
Big kiss on the nose. I think that's perfectly fair enough after winning the group at Crufts. So Ruth Barber coming into the ring to make the presentation here for the group winner. Many congratulations to Franco Barberi. Big smiles all round. You just have to be careful the Labrador doesn't eat the rosette. They do have a tendency to do that. Weimaraner in second, barking at the camera. German shorthead pointer in third, and the Irish Water Spaniel taking group four. Beautiful shot of the Labrador there. No, and hopefully we'll see a lap of honour. We will. Many congratulations to the Gundog Group winner for 2013, the Labrador Retriever.
And he's just been phased a little bit by the cameras there, but Franco getting, there he goes, he's getting back together now. Franco, very competitive, a keen exhibitor, but he'll be delighted with this win. So we'll see him again tomorrow night to compete for Best in Show.
So there we have it, Saturday's group won by the Labrador Retriever. So you can see all the paraphernalia being trundled off the green carpet for this evening. Of course, we'll be back tomorrow for the biggest day of Crufts 2013, its Best in Show Day. Hope you've enjoyed the coverage and please do join us again tomorrow. Good night.
Hi, I'm Victoria Pendleton. I'm probably known best for being a track cyclist on the Great Britain team. I'm a double gold and silver Olympic medalist and 9 times world champion. I'd like to introduce you to the other passion in my life. These are my 2 beautiful dogs, Stella and Mr. Jonty, that I've had for 2.5 years since they were pups. My dogs play a very important role in my life. Not only are they my new training partners, but I think they're my soulmates too. And I love nothing more than spending my time relaxing with them and taking them for walks. As a dog lover, I can't wait to attend Crufts this year. It's the biggest and best celebration of dogs.
Was the dream team.